So, the idea here is that, okay, if you have a system of equations, that instead, like in class, you were written, everything was written as in form of like, sum of the forces equal to zero, and the sum of the moment equal to zero. But now, you ask to solve a system that says, hey, x equal to b, right? So what I'm gonna try to do today is go from this way of writing that equation to this way of writing that equation, and let you know exactly what pertains to what and how to construct the A and B matrices, okay? So for that, I'm just gonna take a general example where you have a system, let's say, that has m external forces, right? And external moment. We'll do I internal force. And what I call internal forces are actually the forces that that will go in the reaction make the reaction matrix, which is the X matrix. And let's say we have a J internal moment as well. Okay, so what I'm going to do is rewrite these two equations that we're all familiar with and then translate it to these, and we'll see where each number lies, okay? So for that, I'm going to need to define a couple of parameters where, let's say I call, where F would be the direction, direction of force. So we're going to define quantity F and P that pertain to the I forces. We're going to define a FJ quantity that is literally FJ. Which will be the direction of internal moment. Okay, now we need to define two equivalent quantities that for the external forces. So I run out of alphabet and word here, so let's say Fm and Pm as well as Fn. So I guess just based on this, we understand that so the Fm vector is just the point about the direction of the force of external forces for any given external force. This will be the point of application of any given external force, and this will be the direction of any given external moment, right? So if we take the first equation where we said the sum of the forces equal to zero, that's essentially to say that so if you rewrite that, you'll find that the sum of the forces, the internal forces, equal to sum of the external forces, right? So if we rewrite that all out, you would get something that looks like So let's say this force, like the F, F force has component F, Fx, Ffy, and Ffz, where these would be the unit vector, the direction of this different forces. This here will tell you that the I force would be F, F1 in the x direction plus F, F2 in the x direction plus all the way to the F, I in the x direction equal to some of the forces, external forces. We got M external forces, so you get F external 1 in the x direction plus F external 2 in the x direction as well, all the way to F external in, this is M, in the x direction. You will do the same thing along the y axis, so you can get something that says FF1 y axis plus y axis. So, this is some equation it could only be written as just, well, I guess the F1 force multiplied by the unit vector in the x direction, right, of that component, plus the F2 force multiplied by this unit vector as well, all the way. And the same thing could be said about this side of the equation, where you get F external 1 multiplied by this unit external 1 as well. And then we can expand that all the way down. So essentially, what I'm trying to say is that everything that pertains to the force in the x direction is just the magnitude of the force multiplied by the unit vector in that direction, both for the unknown and the known quantities, right? So all this could be translated into a matrix form where, I'm going to do it down here. So eventually, what matrix algebra is just a clever way to rewrite a long string of algebraic equation into a compact form. So that would pretend, that would just turn into this unit vector x in the I direction, this unit vector, so this is for the first component, the unit vector for the second component, all the way here for the unit vector here for the I component. Then you have a unit vector here for the y component of the first force, the unit vector for the y component of the second force, a unit vector of the y component of the I force, unit vector of the z component, the first one, z component of the second one, all the way to the z component of the I component. And then if you multiply that by F1, F2, all the way to Fi, the way matrix multiplication works is that all you do is just multiply this quantity with this quantity with this quantity with that. So it's just like multiply the row by the columns, right? And since we have I different coefficient here, we need to have I different forces on this side as well. So all you do is just this multiplication. The same thing will go for, so eventually, because our system, we're only dealing with like three internal, we only have three equations on this, so you would have this type of equation, right? I'm just gonna go ahead. So just, I guess the general idea here to remember is that on the side of the matrix that pertains to forces, the way you fill in this equation, the matrix force, is just with the unit vectors, right? So remember that. I am going to go ahead and... Well, the same thing could be said from the other side with external forces here, where you would have, what is it? The unit vector for the first one all the way down, and this quantity where external forces. But since we already know the external forces, instead of writing them here, you can just multiply them by the way, because there's no unknown on this side, right? So what I'm saying here is that the matrix B, the upper portion of the matrix B would be the first external force that you know multiplied by this unit vector in that direction. And then the same thing goes here, the first external force is multiplied by the y, and the first external force here multiplied by the z. And then you will do this for all the different forces that you have on this side and just sum them up. Alright? So I'm going to go ahead and erase this. Is anyone copying? No? Okay. So now when it comes to the moment, the way the moment works is that each force that you have, should it be internal or external force that you would have, will contribute to moment, right? And the way you calculate that, we saw in class that the moment induced by force is just r cos, where r is the position vector, cos that force, the force that you're interested in. So if we use this expression and extend it to what we have there, the moment induced by the first I, let's say the first internal force, right? It's just going to be equal to the position vector of that first internal force cos with F1 internal, right? You can just as well write this as F, which is the norm of the first internal force that you're interested in, that you will multiply by R, first one internal, which is the unit vector, cos with the unit vector of like R internal. That's the, these two segments are equivalent, right? Now, the way I'm trying to go with this is that if you go back to the file that you were given, this is the unit vector, this is the magnitude.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah. So I put the hat in there and the other one is around. Well, slide out. Okay, yeah, there it comes. So way I was going with this is that the good thing, the way the file that you guys had, the structure is that the advantage that we have here is like all quantity was were actually calculated or were defined with respect to the origin, the 0, 0 point. And that's to say that if you want the unit vector, the position vector, FR1 in this case, so F internal is one of the reactions that you need to solve for, right? Which would be this force here. Now, if you notice, this force, like this line, is correlated with this line. This is where the force is applied, and this is the magnitude you're trying to solve for, and this is the line of action, right? So, what I'm saying, the R1 here, which is the position vector, would just be this quantity here, within your file. And the, what I call the unit vector would be this unit vector, where you would say, and by unit vector, I'm saying for that first example, for instance, if you were to rewrite this equation for the first example, you're just going to have F internal 1, right, which is an unknown in this case, which is one thing that you need to solve for, that you will multiply by the R1 component, which is 1, 1, 1, and then you want to dot that with this one here, the unit vector, which will be 1 over the square root of 1 squared plus 6 squared plus 3 7 squared. And just filling the blank. So that's this will be, what is it, 6 square root of 1 squared plus 6 squared plus 7 squared, and then this will be negative 7 so 1 squared plus 6 squared plus 7 squared. So this here would be one, like how you find the actual component of the force contributed by the first internal force. That's how much moment it contributes to the overall system. The idea now is this, like you need to apply, so this is just like a general case. For it, however many forces you have, you just really need to do the same kind of math, right? So if we call this quantity, let's say A4, right? A4, it doesn't matter. And then we come to like the second, so this is our A matrix, we already filled out, it's up, which pretend two forces. The bottom now that pertains to moment, what you need to do is, there will be moment induced by the internal forces and moment induced by internal moment as well. The moment induced by internal forces will be given by this, where if you want the x component of the I component of this quantity, so that would just be A4, which in this case will be a vector. Now you would dot with the I component, the I unit vector, right? The same thing goes for the j, which would dot with j and A4 dot with k, like this. So you would just extend the same idea for however many forces you have. So in our case, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 different forces that we need to solve for. And for that, we would have one column that pertains to the first one, the second column that pertains to the second one, and four columns for those. Where it's the same idea. So all you need to do is just take the unit vector that actually pertains to that force that you're interested in, cross it with this position vector, add it with any direction that you're interested in, and just like fit into the matrix. Now, this is the moment contributed by the different forces. Now, if we're interested in the moment contributed by the actual internal moment, so let's say this one here. So what I was saying is, so we have sum of the moment equal to 0. I'll wrap that in sum of the internal moment. So we saw earlier that, okay, the sum of the internal moment for the first, the I force would just be F1 internal, the magnitude of that, multiplied by Ri1, cos it with F unit vector 1 internal. You would do the same thing for F2 internal. And then we just populate that until we get to FII, which is the last. That's our general system there. So that's RII cos it with FII and back like this. And then the same way applies for the moment contributed to with by the external forces on this side. So the first external force would contribute the moment that's F external 1 multiplied by R external 1 cos it with F external 1 unit vector, the same thing all the way goes to F external M force external M cos it with F. So this gives you a moment equation that pertains only to forces. So this is the moment contributed by different forces. So that you need to add the moment generated by pure moment itself. And the good thing with pure moment is that you don't need to know where they apply. In general, when a moment trying to rotate an entire plane, so it doesn't depend, it's not dependent on where you put it. So you can move it anywhere. And that's just a fancy way to say that within your file, this quantity here where it says where the moment is applied, it's not relevant. Because you can put a moment anywhere. It'll just have the same effect, right? So for that case, all you need to do is just do, you just need to add the moment itself, so like moment one plus moment two, however moment you have. In this case, we add the J moment. And in this case, you need to add moment itself one plus moment itself two plus right? So this here is yet another just linear equation. Like it's just a bunch. So if you plug this down in like the three different components, you're gonna get three different lines of equation, right? One in the II, the one in the J, and one in the K. So how do you turn that again into a matrix form? You just use the same idea that we had earlier, where you will know that when you create a matrix that goes like this, the way you multiply, you populate every element with this will be multiplied by this, right? So in this case, we established earlier that the B matrix that we're interested in would be those magnitude here, and this magnitude, right? So if we put those in here, so we have F1 all the way, and we have the M's down here. The first element that goes here should be the element that multiplies this F1. And the element that multiplies this F1 in this quantity is, we established earlier, it was equal to this, gathered with the I component. Right? So this feeds into the first element. The other one that goes for like the second force will feed into this. So eventually you're just going to populate. So however many forces you have would have each one column here. And however moment you have would just be the I component of this moment in here, the J component down here, and the K component. Alright. So, any questions as well? No? So, if we want to generalize this, we'll see that the way the matrix will actually be constructed is that you're going to have, we said earlier that these, like for the F forces, this was just the unit vector. So our unit vector here was just going to be, so this is going to be U1, I, U1, J, U1, K, and then you're just going to do that for however many forces you have. So we have U1, I here, not U1, I. U, I, J, and U, I, K. And if you noted earlier, when we wrote it at the force equation, there was no moment contribution in it, right? So, and because our X matrix is filled with forces 1, all the way to forces I, and then moment 1, so all the way to moment M, we also need to put the moment contribution in those different columns. But since there was 0, in the x direction, you're just going to get questions, a bunch of zeros, a bunch of zeros, and a bunch of zeros. That's how you fill in. That's the top portion of the matrix. Now, the bottom portion of the matrix, we saw that forces as well as moment contributed moment. So the moment contributed by forces 1, we saw earlier that it was equal to R1, which is the position vector of this force, cost with the F direction, which was just the unit vector of the force, 1, that should adapt with the I component. You do the same thing here, R1, cost with F1, adapt it with the J, and R1, cost F1, gather with the K. And then you're just going to populate that for however many forces you have. And then when it comes down to for the moment, we saw also that the moment only contributed whatever they have in that direction. There was no cost product involved on that. So that's just going to be U moment in the X direction for the first one, U moment in the Y direction for the first one, U moment in the Z direction for the first one, and you're just going to incorporate it for however many moment you have. And then this will be the structure of your X matrix, and then the B matrix on this side, we're just going to reset earlier as well, that was just fx down by 1, this time being the magnitude that you will multiply by the unit vector x down by 1 in the I direction. Same thing, fx down times the unit vector x down by 1 in the J direction, fx down by 1 multiplied by the unit vector x down by 1 in the K direction. So that's how you calculate the upper portion for the B matrix. And keep in mind that when I say fx1, I'm just generalizing. They could be however many x1 forces you want. So you're just going to populate those and sum them. The same goes for the moment. For the moment, you're going to have fx1 multiplied by r1 external causes with f external 1 or x external in general. Then you're going to have the moment 1 multiplied by its unit vector in the I direction. F external multiplied by R external plus F external. This is I here. We got it with the I vector. J plus M. Down here you're going to have f external plus r external plus the f and vector data of the k component plus the moment times q of moment external multiplied in the k direction. So that is in essence what the A, B, and C matrices are. And that's how you build them. Any question?
So the inputs give us external couple moments with just an axis rotation. How do you convert that to like the I tape?
So wait, could you point to this exactly?
So for example, like we've got magnitude 11 newton meters, whatever it is.
Yeah.
It's acting along this axis.
Yeah.
But to use the matrix, right, we need that broken into rotation about I, J, K.
Exactly. So, if you notice, what I call R, like let's say we're just like dealing with that force 1, right? The R1 force, we're just going to, the R1 vector in this case, would be the point of application of that external. So, let's say we're dealing with just external forces, because whether it's external force or internal force is the same idea, right? So let's say we're dealing with the force that you pointed out earlier, the 11. So the R component, which is the position vector, would be 0, 1, 0, 1, right? That would be this quantity here, this R here. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Sorry, I had to go so we know the wrong way.
Okay.
Yeah, this line. So magnitude and direction of external couple moments.
Okay.
So that just gives us the magnitude and axis of rotation. Right?
Exactly. So because when 3D, the it's not that intuitive to know, you know, like in 2D it's always going to be pointing to the J, the K direction or whatnot. In this, because when 3D, it could be pointing in any different way as possible. So what you need to do is just multiply this moment by the unit vector in every single direction. So in order to get the contribution of this moment in the I direction, it's going to be this multiplied by 4 divided by the magnitude of this. Sense? And the J would be added by moment. Okay, yeah, you could dot it, or you can just, if you dot it, you're not taking the direction. Well, what I was saying, 4 multiplying by this, essentially doing the same thing as you would if you were to dot it. Because if you want to use a dot product, what you need to do is just multiply this, right, by this unit vector, then dot it with the I component. But that essentially comes down to taking this two component out, because this will be perpendicular, and then fall down to 0.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
Any other question? Nope. Was that clear? Cool. So I'll be around if there's any questions while you guys are trying to deal with this, but otherwise that's the general idea.